as far as you know, having dreams as a kid and that type of thing, coming fresh out of the league, your first season as a coach in the NHL to win the Stanley Cup's got to be just beyond belief.
It starts at a young age. You dream about winning the Stanley Cup. This was my personal dream to hoist this thing. I never got to do it as an NHL player, but to do it as an NHL coach means just as much. I always talked about what those dreams were. Well, the dreams was to share it with friends, family, the community, having the situation to present itself for all the support that's happened and people that have given it to me over all these years to finally give back, to see the smile on the face. I'm just elated. The dream has finally come true.
Kind of make it all worthwhile when I used to hear your dad talk about whether it was days, I think, outside of Winnipeg and they put Vaseline on your face and they couldn't bring you in from the first hockey stick and you're breaking bulbs and whatnot around the house, that when you start thinking back to those days and all your memories, that it finally does capitalize with the cup.
It truly does. I mean, all those things, the people, like I said, that have sacrificed, especially my parents, my family, my sister, all those years that we put in to have a moment like this, to have a true celebration with the Stanley Cup. It's a Canadian hockey player's dream and a family dream to have this all come together because of the work that's gone in, because of the countless hours that have portrayed to have this situation kind of now come to light. It truly is fully exciting.
It's quite the road too, if you look at it, the year, coaching change and, you know, things could have changed more and you stuck around and you made it happen. Just to be part of that must have been really cool.
It truly was. Our staff was pretty amped up. We weren't happy. We lost a great coach with Mike Yeo. Craig Berube took over. I came from the Eye in the Sky to help out with run the forwards on the bench. And you know what? We just kind of started chipping away. We came in there with a lot of accountability. We wanted to make sure that we continue to push these guys every day, and we talked about getting better. We were last place in the league at that time. No one was proud. It was embarrassing, quite frankly. We knew we had a great team, but once the guys started to play for each other, once they started to see the belief in system with the guy beside them, and you know, everyone talks about those type of cliches, but that's exactly what the turnaround was about. And that's how we built a team from that moment on, and it ended up going to the playoffs, and now we're a special group for the rest of our lives.
What does it mean to you to bring the cup to Lakeshore? To bring it back to the area,
it's everything. I've talked about this countless times in the sense of where you're from, where your community, the support that I was given throughout so many years as my playing career, and the rest of my coaching career. I know these people deserve it. They've stuck behind me. I've had so many people come up to me over the last month since returning home with a lot of congratulations, and I'm just so excited for them to see the presence of this trophy, to touch it, to take pictures with it, to come out and still continue to support me. I'm truly honored.
Thanks. People talk about just how difficult of a trophy it is to win. Can you kind of put that into words, like series after series and the grind it is to go through the Stanley Cup playoffs and finally be able to hoist the cup?
Absolutely. To see these players, the grind that you're talking about, they push to another level that I'd never seen possible. I never got to that far as a player, and rightfully so. I was probably beat up a little bit by then, but these guys went out there, they laid their hearts out there. We had guys coming back with injuries. We had guys that we had to push through injuries and guys that continued to just play for each other. And to watch that firsthand, to have your hands on it, to be able to touch everybody in a right way, to push guys and keep their confidence level up and know that they could do it, it was unbelievable to see firsthand. It truly was. The community support of St. Louis as well, the support we had throughout the country, having all these Canadian hockey players, you could feel all these different emotions go through. But to watch it firsthand, these guys compete the way they did was truly special.
You get the feeling too, Otter, that for kids, you know, whether it's a, you know, an Adam or a novice kid that shows up on Sunday, sees a cup, gets a picture taken with it, you know, to know that you're a kid from Stony Point, I know you played around a lot of different spots, that maybe that lights a fire in their dream as well, that it is possible.
Well, we're lucky. We have a pretty good hockey hotbed here with a lot of great NHL players that have made it and coaches, and you're absolutely right. I'm going to have my jerseys up there, from my St. Anne's High School jersey, from my Bell River Canadians, my Leamington Flyers, and obviously my OHL team with the Windsor Spitfire. So all those local community teams that help grow the person I am, it can definitely happen to somebody else real easily, and I hope it does, because you know what it is? It's something that I was very fortunate to be involved in this local community, and I hope hope it does light some kids' dreams and they have the same type of future that I had.
Okay. Looking ahead towards Sunday, our media, our social media pages have been totally abuzz with people who are excited about the viewing on Sunday. You could be walking into a mob scene. How does that feel?
You know what? It's probably going to be pretty emotional, to be honest with you. I've kind of, you get those happy tears every once in a while, and my emotions, I wear them on my sleeve. So like, to see all the people, like I said, with the amount of support that's going to happen on Sunday, it really is. It really is something special. I'm really looking forward to it. I hope people enjoy it as much as I do. The Stanley Cup is a special own celebrity all by itself, so I can't wait to see everybody's faces light up when I get to bring her in.
Did you ever touch the cup before you got to hoist it?
You know what I did? I posted a picture when I was about 10 with my dad. We saw it at the Hockey Hall of Fame, and I was hugging it. But at that age, you don't really know. So I'm going to tell anybody else, get the picture, because you know what? You never know when you get to touch this thing.